Good morning, sir.
Good morning, sir.
I am Professor Sakthivel from Department of Electrical Engineering. Today I am going to teach about the basic circuit elements, basic electric circuit elements. So in electric circuit, there are three passive circuit elements, namely resistor, second one, inductor, and third one, capacitor. So most of the electric circuit consists of combination of these three circuit elements. And this resistors are represented by R, and inductors are represented by the symbol L, and capacitor is represented by C. And the symbols are resistor and inductor and capacitor. So first we discuss about resistor. First we consider a simple electric circuit which consists of only resistor. So before going to this, we should know what is resistance. What is resistance? Resistance is the property of the material or element which opposes the flow of current. We know that. What do you mean current? What do you mean current?
Flow of
electrons. So the electrons must flow from one point to another point. So voltage is defined as the potential difference. Potential difference. There are minus and plus. Minus and plus. So without this potential difference, electron cannot flow through. If you consider a tank, now we consider a tank, water tank. If it is filled with this level of water, what is the flow of water through this pipe?
Zero.
Zero. What is the reason? There is no existence of pressure in between these two points. So if there exists a pressure difference, if you consider, now the level is up to this. So we have two levels. This L1 and L2. So the difference between L2 and L1 causes the flow of water through the pipe. So the flow of water through the pipe is nothing but current. It's nothing but current. So without any pressure, there cannot be any flow of water. So similarly, without any pressure difference, potential, electromotive force, it is also called as EMF. Electromotive force. The force, the basic force required for the motion of electrons. For the motion of electrons. So only it is known as EMF. Force required. Force for electron movement. Is known as EMF. So now we have a resistor. What do you mean resistor means? Now there is a potential difference. So electrons moves from one place to another place. So after this, it moves freely. But there is a substance which is known as resistance. The nature of the substance which opposes the flow of current through it. So it creates some obstacles. So So it limits the flow of electrons. It limits the flow of electrons. It is known as resistance. And that material is known as resistor. And the material is known as resistor. And the value of the resistor is given by R is equal to rho L by A. This material can be made up of aluminium, can be made up of copper. Copper is a conductor, but every conductor should have some opposition capacity for the flow of electrons. If you consider a material with the length of L and cross section of A, so the resistance of this material is given by rho L by A, and this rho is specific resistivity. It depends upon the nature of the material. It is different for different materials. If you consider and length and cross section, it does not vary. So mainly the resistance of the material depends upon the specific resistivity. And according to the Ohm's law, now so there is a flow of current and there is a potential V. So according to the Ohm's law, this voltage or current, voltage is directly proportional to current, and the proportionality is replaced by the property of the substance. Here the property of the substance is resistance, which limits the current. So V is equal to I into R. We can use this property of resistance in so many places for an application like immense water heater. The nature of the resistor, it dissipates the energy in the form of the heat. So V, the power dissipated, is given by I square R. What is the amount of current? The square of the current in the value of the resistance, which gives us the power. It is dissipated in the form of the heat. Next one, inductor. Now we construct an inductor circuit. So first of all, we should know what is inductors. The property of the substance which opposes sudden change of current, which opposes the flow of current, is known as resistance. Sudden change of current is known as inductance. It is represented by L. Sudden change of current. And the voltage that presents across the inductor is represented by V suffix L. So V suffix L can be written as L into di by dt. That is change in current. The nature of the inductor is to store the energy in the electromagnetic field. We know that whenever a conductor, if you consider an iron core, now we are winding a conductor over the core. Now it becomes an inductor. So for example, if consider this is a conductor, straight line conductor. So it has some resistance. Whenever you wound this conductor over a core, now my hand act as a core. For example, in our body, our bone structure is nothing but the core. Think about what happened if you have any bones we have no dimension. We have no dimension. But in case of inductor, we have two types of inductors, core inductor, and this is iron core, and another one is air core. Air core is like a bubble. Air core is like a bubble. Inside and outside, there is no any core, only air is present. So, iron core inductor, also air core inductor. So, how we say that inductance is nothing but opposes sudden change of current. If you consider the distance is 10 meter, 10 meter, and this point is A and this point is B. Now, a person runs from point A to B at a speed of 1 meter per second. 1 meter per second. So, how much time he takes to run from A to B? 10 seconds. Now, the same length of 10 meter is changed as this point is A and this point is B, and this total length is 10 meter. Can he complete within 10 seconds? It is not possible, because due to this bending nature of the subway, it takes some more time. So similarly, it opposes. So it is compared with the sudden, it opposes the sudden change of current. Sudden change of current. So we can use this property of inductor VL equal to L into di by dt. We all know the connections of fluorescent lamp. Connections of fluorescent lamp. So here, two electrodes. Starter, and this one is choke. Choke is nothing but an inductor. Inductor can also be called as choke, and it is a switch. It is a power supply. So it is filled with some gases. Filled with some gases. When we switch on this circuit, what will happen? The circuit will get closest. The circuit will get closest. It is a starter. The nature of the starter is bimetallic. It is made up of bimetallic steel. When it is heated up, it closes and then it melts and opens. So due to the cooling effect, it once again makes an contact. So there is a frequent open and close of the switch. Frequent open and close of the switch. So due to this starter effect, this choke inductor produces a high voltage. Produces an high voltage. Due to this application of this high voltage, now these gases get ionized. These gases get ionized. So the nature of the current is to take the least resistive path. Least resistive path. Now it offers the least resistive path. So the fluorescent lamp will glow. At the time of glowing of this fluorescent lamp, if you remove the starter, it will does not make any effect. So now we discuss how it creates an high voltage. So V is equal to L into di by dt. So VL equal to, consider L equal to some 4 milli henry. 4 milli henry. So 4 into 10 power minus 3. Now consider, and 2 seconds of time. 2 seconds of time, that is dt equal to 2 seconds, or we can take in terms of milliseconds. For example, 2 milliseconds and this dt, and di, the difference in current, may be 0.5 amps. So now we substituting this values, di is 0.5 divided by, and this dt 2 milliseconds, 2 into 10 power minus 3. Normally this time will be very crucial. For example, I have taken 2 milliseconds. Actually it will take in terms of nanoseconds or microseconds. Nanoseconds and microseconds. So it gets cancels, and how much we get? Only 1 volt, isn't it? But if it is in terms of nanoseconds, actually it takes only, the process will be completed in nanoseconds. It is 10 power minus 9, so finally we will get 2 into 10 power 6, that is 2 mega volt. But our in fluorescent lamp, it creates an 100,000 volt. The applied voltage is only 230 volt. Applied voltage is only 230 volt, but at the time of this process it creates 100 volt. So we can use this inductor, and most of the cases all the electrical appliances, whether it is a washing machine, fridge, whatever the thing, the motor is made up of windings, which is nothing but a inductor. Next one, capacitor. Now we consider two metallic plates. So this is also metal A, this M1 and M2, two metallic plates. When these two plates are conducting materials separated by some dielectric media, this is dielectric medium, there are so many dielectric media such as mica, glass, air is the best dielectric medium. Why we call it as a dielectric medium? It may be the electric property or insulating property. It possesses two electrical properties. First of all, it acts as an insulator, and second one is conductor. When we apply a voltage, simply it acts as an insulator. After certain potential difference, it will be converted into, or it acts as a conductor. For example, if there is a line, overhead line that goes very nearest to our house. Consider this is an overhead line which goes very nearest to house. We keep 1 meter distance. You will not get any shock. Do you get any shock? No. If it is 11 kV also. If you maintain such 5 cm or 10 cm, what will happen? You will definitely get a shock. What is the reason? Even though there is a gap, you are getting a shock. What is the reason? Because air is the dielectric media. Because depends upon the distance, it acted as an insulator. Now it become as a conductor. So the voltage is 30 kilovolt per centimeter. 30 kilovolt per centimeter. That is the distance. Distance between the plate. So at that time, the conductor is one plate of the capacitor, and our hand or our body will act as an another plate of the capacitor, and the dielectric media which acted as insulator now converted into conductor. So the current takes the lowest resistive path. Our body is a lowest resistive path at that time. So the current flows through our body, so we get the shock. And nature of the capacitor is does not allow any sudden change of voltage. It is just opposite to the inductor. Inductor does not change, does not allow any sudden change of current, but it does not allow any sudden change of voltage. Thank you.
Really, really.